is a Group C clash here in Lithuania. It's a key game as third place 8-4 Neptunas Klaipėda take on fourth place 7-5 Ventspils. Well, the home side, Neptunas, are on a poor run of form just now, having lost their last three in the competition. Only Rosa Radom, seventh in this group. The Barkin Bears, bottom of Group A. And Telenet Ost End, sixth in Group D, have a worse record coming into this round than any other. But as you can see, four games in Group C on game day 13. Asphalt won by 20 at home to Rosa yesterday, so they are short of a top two finish. Neptunas take on Ventspils. And there you can see the other games in this one as Pauk try and get their way into a top five finish. It is, remember, the top four definitely into the next round and the best place, fifth place teams. As you can see, this is what the Group C standings look like. And Klaipėda, 8-4. If they win their next two games and Asphalt lose their last, then Neptunas will top the group. However, should they lose here tonight, then they will drop to fourth. Ventspils, well, they come into this one looking for a second or third place finish. They can't catch Lyon, who are too far in front after that win last night. So let's have a look at the two rosters, starting with the visitors, number 11. Evgelis Zelionis is their leading point scorer, 13.2. When it comes to assists and steal, well, look no further than number five, Willie Dean, and number 30 there, Ronald Zakis. He is their leading rebounder. Well, as for the home side, can they snap this losing streak in this competition? And this is their roster coming into this one. No injuries for them. Jake is back from an ankle injury, and Sixnius is in after muscle treatment. Jimmy Barron, number 20, is their leading point scorer, 15.7. He's eighth on the list in the competition for rebounds. Look to number 23, Mindaugas Kachnias, at 5.8. Assists and steals, well, they go to number 19, Larry Drew. Drew, 5.5, 10th on the list in terms of leading rebounders in the assists in the competition so far. When you look down at the percentages for 2 points scored and 3 points scored, well, it's very similar. Ventspils have been scoring 50.8% of their two-pointers. Neptunas, 51%. When it comes to three-pointers, 36% for Ventspils, 36.9% for Neptunas. So this one could be very, very close as we see Willie Dean lead out the visitors. Lauren Campbell, number 55, the last to come out for Ventspils. Double figures in his last three matches. Campbell had his best game against Varese a couple of weeks ago. Now, how about the home side? Well, they had a big win last weekend in the Lithuanian League against second place Lodz Kabelis. They snap a seven-game losing streak in all competitions. Their first win since December the 14th, when they beat Varese on the road. Well, the MC's certainly doing his level best to lift the atmosphere here in the Civitturio Arena. Sharakauskas. Larry Drew. What a big role he'll have to play tonight, along with the next man out, number 20, Jimmy Barron. Known for his three-point ability is Barron. Sharakauskas comes up. This is Kachinas, key rebounder for Neptunas. Larry Johnson played nine games this season since the 9th of November when he was signed from the Maine Red Claws. The 19-year-old Blauskas, five appearances this season, played 60 minutes against Pauk last week for 9 points. And Gerard Grant, the last to come out. Dennis Solomatis, the head coach for Neptunas. And he'll shake hands with his opposite number, Carlos Wisniewski, who is a household name in Latvian basketball. Ventspils. As we have a look at the with the officials for this one, Panagiotis Anastopoulos of Greece, Malachewski of Poland, and Marcos Michalidis of Switzerland will be blowing the whistle here in Lithuania's third largest city on the coast of the Baltic Sea, about 300 kilometres northeast of the capital, Vilnius. And the starting five for Ventspils: Dean Campbell, Zelionis, Zakis, and Jasenox. Jasenox coming in for Stelle, number 21. And he's coming off the best game of his season last week in terms of efficiency, 16. Jasenox, so he gets the nod. Wisniewski, former player who won 6 Latvian titles, 5 of them with Ventspils. Also led the team to third place in the FIBA Europe Champions Cup and the ULEB Cup quarters. Second stint with the club. Now, Klaipeda starts with Majeka, Drew, Kachinas, Johnson and Grant. And no real surprises there. Sharakauskas misses out in the starting five. Avilish Shikshnius. And you see the back of him back in the roster after muscle treatment. Danis Adomaitis, the head coach, been in charge since 2015, a former player, won the EuroLeague with Zalgiris Kaunas. So last minute words from both sets of coaches, and we are just about ready to get this one underway. Remember, second versus fourth, a key game in the chase for a high finish to get as good a draw as possible in the postseason. So we're almost ready to go. Tunis just taking that time to come out. It's been good to get back to winning ways after a month with no W's. Can they bring an end to this three-game losing streak in this competition? I mentioned that only three clubs, including Ostend, had a worse record. Well, Ostend won last night at home, 82-74, to snap their losing streak. Would it be the turn of Neptunas Klaipėda tonight. It certainly looks as if they mean business. The officials struggling to get the starting five out onto court. Some last minute words from Larry Drew. And we are ready to go here. So the intensity looks to be there from Neptunus Klaipeda. Can they get a better event spills? It will be the home side in the white strip attacking the board away to our left-hand side to get the first possession. And the first three-pointer comes in and is scored. Well, what a start that is from Larry Drew. And Neptunus fans will be hoping at that sets the pattern for the rest of the evening. When it comes to three-point percentages, well, Drew hasn't put up the most and he hasn't scored the most as the hook shot comes in from Zakis, but it's well off target. Jimmy Barron's put up the most. He's put up 79, converted 41 of those. That's a 52% conversion rate. He's been backed up by Johnson, 17 from 48, and well, they've done it again. They've stuck in another three-pointer. What a start. Two from downtown. Three-point percentages for Ventspils. Well, Egor Stell is the biggest threat. He's put up the most, hit the most, 17-36 at 47%. So big disparity between the amount of three-pointers put up. Stell 36, Barron 79, Johnson 49. As the layup brings up two. Drew, well, that was number 17 from 57 this season from downtown. Kachi Naswell, he's been less successful as Grant can't find the layup and gets someone landing on his right foot, so he's just hobbling around a little bit at the moment. But Drew trying to find himself some space. Lovely skill from Drew, takes a step back, too much on it, comes back off the iron, rebound falls to Yanni Kanokos. Here is Dean. Dean finding support with Yanni Kanokos. Dean again over the top. Is Zakis. Zakis again fails to find the range. The first hook shot just about hit the bottom of the net. The second one hits the iron. Here comes another three-pointer. That one lips out from Amari Johnson. Johnson coming off the best game of the season last week. A double-double. Scored 6 points against Ventspils the first time they met. Well, it started well, but three-pointers have just gone off the boil a little bit. Ventspils won the corresponding game at home, 66-61. And again, no joy in the paint for Ronald Zakis, whose radar is firmly out. Johnson finds the target. So an explosive start from Neptunus. Ventspils have not been rattled. You wouldn't imagine they would be. Bounce pass in. That's a lovely bounce pass. But again, very wayward. This time Zelionis, who is pretty good in the paint. 72% of his two-pointers he's scored. And, well, 38 and 33%. Need to improve on that, do both sides. Ajayka puts through for two, but he'll have a chance to make it a 3-point play. Just hooked on the arm by Eleni Chiannokos. It's gone against Gorbis. Gorbis coming in. He's in on the rotation, but here we go then. Jacob makes it a 3-point play, and the lead is 7. Dean Zakis. Support comes from Campbell. Campbell weighing up the option, tries to play it through, comes off the foot of Katsinas. Katsinas off. Shukshnius comes in. Here is Campbell. Had to get rid of that. Did Chiannokos, and Dean puts through for 3. So Dean, 36 years of age, 36 years young, I'm sure he might say. He's won championships in Bulgaria, France and Italy. Had a season high 22 points against Neptunas, and a 25 point efficiency in the first game this season. And he's in the thick of the action again as Majeka puts him on the floor. Back of Jimmy Barron as Steve puts up the first. And gets the second, and they're back to within 2 as we approach the midpoint of the opening quarter. Neptunas 11, Ventspils 9. Here is Drew. Space in the middle there for Krakauskas. Comes out to Barron. Barron, little jump shot from midway, comes back off the iron. And Gulbis picks up the rebound as Dean brings it up over halfway. Dean backing into Drew. He fancies this on the post up. The little jump shot doesn't quite drop for him. And Krakauskas gets the rebound and gives it to Drew. Drew swings it back out, and Johnson for travelling. And Johnson comes off after that infringement. Campbell just seeing some pointers from coach Wisniewski. Pressure applied. Chiknius with Ventspils bring it up over. Rebound comes back out. Drew, wondering why he's got the number 11 or 2 on the back. Drew the second. He is son of Larry Drew, the assistant coach at the Cleveland Cavaliers. That's why. Substitution. Stell. And a long range effort. Oh, how's that not drop? And Chiannokos with the shot from right on the edge of the circle as Drew goes through the middle. Layup for 2. He's drawn the foul on the way in down the channel. Leonis just interfering with Drew on his route through to the basket, and he comes off. Drew, 3-point play, back up to 5 now. So better from Neptunus. Svensfeld's going the other way. Dean. In terms of 2% of scoring, goes up top. And Grant gets involved with Zakis for the foul. Dean going up high. Didn't quite have enough on it. I think Zakis was looking for the alley-oop. Tunis turn its red on the foul fronts. It's Yanitianokas right from the edge of the 2-point zone, finds the target. Here is Shiknius, whose shot comes back off the iron into the hands of awaiting Stel. Dean swings it out left, and again right from the edge. This one doesn't drop for Chinokas. Barron, Grant, back to Barron. Grant at the free throw line, finds the target. There goes Stel. His greatest game against Neptunus first time round. Willie Dean drains a three-pointer. Looks to the bench to say, I'm going to do it all myself. Where's the support now? Barron swings it out to that right-hand side. This is Kachunas into Kachunas. Kachunas loses out under pressure from Yanitianokas. Yanitianokas again. Bounce pass into Gulbis. Gulbis posts up. Hook shot comes back away and Barron picks up the rebound. Grant tries to provide the screen but can't do it effectively. Long ranger whips back out and that's good skill from Kachunas. He was fully aware that Kachunas was behind him. And no offensive rebounds for the visitors as the foul comes in. Still on Kachunas. First one is away. Kachunas. Inside the final 90 seconds of the first quarter. Nicholas Zelionis comes back into the fray. This is Campbell. Svensfeld's trailing by three, 17-14. Stirr, Campbell. Campbell again. Campbell takes on the three-pointer. Nowhere near. Must have got a touch and the interception. And away goes Kachunas. Oh, he's up for two. Good anticipation from Kachunas. Campbell this time drives down the center. Foul has come in. Going to the line 4-2. Ben Spills. Personal foul for Kachunas, but here are the fast points for Kachunas. This is Stel out of the line. First one is good. Wait. 23 is far better for Fensfield. Two from two. Gets it back to 3 points. Now, can they find a turnover here? Gojunas. Barron. Still going Barron. Bounce pass into Grant. Grant posting up. Lovely skill from Grant. And the foul. Zelionis. Now, did he get it? Elbow in the head. Oh no, he got it. The back of Grant's head in his chin. That is going to hurt. And that time will be stopped for Zelionis. Second foul of the evening for him. And good to see that he's okay. Two fouls for Zelionis. He's had a couple of issues with discipline this year. Fouled out twice this season against USAC and Varese. Grant. Gets them up to 20. Kachinas comes back in. Here comes the press. Still have to go back to retrieve the ball now. 3-pointer comes in totally off balance and keeps it alive. Does Kenichinokas. Zakis. Bounce pass in. Comes off. Majeka, sorry. .9 remaining on the clock. And Dean going to take the inbound. Shot comes in and it's blocked. And that is the end of an entertaining first quarter. Tunis Lepeda have the advantage over Ventspils, 20 points to 16. Well, that's where we stand on the percentages. Look at that, 27% for 2 points for Ventspils. That really needs to improve. 3 points the same. They're good from the free throw line. More rebounds for the home side. Ventspils have got the offensive side ticking eventually. Thought it would be close. It is close. Ventspils surely can't shoot 28% 2 points. Remainder of this match. So leading the way for Neptunas. In terms of points, it's Drew with 6. He had those two early 3-pointers. Willie Dean, well, he has 10 of the 16 for his side. 2 then for Campbell Stout. Yeah, it's there's the opening 3-pointer from Drew. Inside the opening seconds, it just parted for him. He took full advantage of it. And the next one from Kachinas. Dean. Having a good game. 10 points. Just the one miss from the board. 2-pointer. No one person standing out in terms of rebounds. Gorbis has 3 and there's a host of players on both sides on 2. Only Dean leading in terms of points though. Still, Dean. And the second quarter is underway with Neptunas leading by 4. 20 points to 16. Oh, that's much better. Lovely bounce pass. And the layup from Zidens. Just what Ventspils would have wanted at the start of this second quarter. Here is Johnson. Yajunas. Want some space. Here it is. The layup drops. Step. Bringing it forward. Barron turns across and comes back to pick up the mark. And again, off target from Zakis. Number 30. Just having a look at the stats here. Zakis has missed all four shots, and all of them have been from inside the paint. Yeah. So, Yajunas, a swing of the ball, three-point effort. Hits the iron, comes back out into the hands of Chernokos. Time, space, and a three-pointer. It was a flat three-pointer from Zidens. Yajunas, Johnson. Yajunas comes again. Looking for an outlet. Here it is, Barron. Johnson. Posts up, and the rebound falls to Dean, who is fouled by Yajunas as he tries to break. Comes back from Johnson. Yajunas was unaware what was behind him and opting to take the foul. Now Zakis shaking his head. He can't believe it. He doesn't know what's going on. And he obviously doesn't want a consoling word from his teammate. Stout. In comes a three-point effort from Zelionis. And it is a one-point game now, 22-21. Well, that should improve Zakis's mood. The fact his side are close despite his misfiring. Dean trying to inject some pace. And Ventspils have turned this one around and they lead by one now. And enough is enough for Coach Adamaitis. Timeout called. Ventspils. Thanks for listening.
No right side. If you have problems, make foul, but it's more. Yeah. Not shooting.
No, and one.
Yeah. Okay. Let's go.
Okay. Come on.
Well, Ventspils being bailed out, if you like, by their three-pointer. They're up to 35% now from two-point percentages. This is the moment the visitors took the lead. Galas Zelionis, when he's good from inside, 72% in two-pointers coming into tonight. Well, he's just hit a very important three-pointer. Oh, how's that not going? Johnson, Grant. A bit of anger management in that one from Gerard Grant. Martinez back in front by one, all over the place. Yeah. Opened up for him. Oh, and then he loses possession. And Yajunas will bring it away. Here is Barron, lays up for two. Ventspils now take the timeout. Zakis set on the right hand side, just wandering around. There's your second chance points. Ventspils yet to trouble the scorers.
Shoot on the basket. Everybody go. Everybody. You go off the rebound. You. That is just really cheating.
Come on! So, two quick timeouts. Ventspils just trying to take perhaps the momentum out of this Neptunus mini revival. This is Stout. Dean. As Jonas has to stretch, and up goes the layup from Stout. Missed, as was the follow-up. Drew. Fans making themselves heard. Drew. Grant. Grant in a little ding-dong battle. Good rebounding from Johnson. Back out to Barron. Drew wants Johnson out wide. This is outrageous from Barron. Follow-up miss. Rebound. Scored by Johnson. Following up from Johnson, Grant was there too. Back inside to Dean, who goes up and under and on the reverse. Can't find the target. Last off Grant, inbound to Ventspils. Shikshnius coming on. Lips out, rebound. Shikshnius is. Drew. Lovely score from Drew. And it's. I thought he was going to open up from there. He comes back and sets again. Well, since Ventspils took the lead, they haven't scored again. Martinez and Jacob not impressed at all by that call. As he goes through the channel, he was impeded by Ronald Zakis. I think Zakis' day would have gone from pretty bad to even worse if he'd been called for that as well. Perhaps a little fortunate to get away with it, but to get away with it he did. And he was just about to be played in there by Gorbis, who is called for a rather cynical foul. And he will send Martinez to the line. And sportsmanlike from Gorbis. Seven unanswered points for Martinez, becomes eight. Kick to the midpoint of the second quarter. Neptunus have a 7-point lead. Well, they've been up by seven in this game once before. As Campbell brings it forward. Here is Campbell for three. No joy. Last off Johnson. Jakovic. comes on for Stel. Jakovic signed for game day 10, has made three appearances so far. An average of 10 minutes per game. Dean plays it in. And finally, Zakis has his first score. Jacob, nice little bounce pass and lovely little spin. Oh, well, Shignius was on the follow-up. Sharakauskas with the spin but couldn't find the layup. And again, still no second chances. Oh, that's had snow on it when it came down from Gulbis. Back to a four-point game. Sharakauskas still trying to find a spin. And, well, good defense from Zakis. Campbell fouled by Shikshinus. Shikshinus, second foul. He's back in the fold for the first time since game 7. Standard deception as the opposing team goes the line. Two from two, so the crowd will feel pretty happy about that. Disappointment for Ventspils. Jakovic trying to put pressure on Drew. Majika. Drew, Grant on the screen, swung out to that right-hand side, and then Campbell with the foul. Wanted the travelling call against Shikshinius. Good discipline from Natuna so far. Just the two fouls in this quarter. Second by the cherry from Kashinas. Drew up short. Grant with the rebound. Kachunas, he finds the target. Did he have his foot inside? He did, just. Dean swings it out to Gulbis, who puts it up again. Gulbis gives it plenty of hang time and drains another from downtown. So Gulbis, 2 from 3 today. Important three-pointers too. Grant. Shikshinius into Grant. Shot clock is red. Grant takes it on himself. Comes up short. Zakis is there for the rebound. Campbell. Gulbis trying to provide the screen. Here comes Jakovic. Zakis. Shape for a three-pointer and plays it into Gulbis. Gulbis can't find the hook shot, but he was up against it in terms of height on that far side, up against Kachinas. And Gulbis comes out of the action off those 2 three-pointers. Oh, no one at home. Oh, Drew still misses. Well, channel opened up. Drew strode right down it. Verse couldn't find the targets. Jakovic with a three-pointer. Rebound is catching us. Drew. Seen a bit of game time in this one. To Barrett. Barrett over the top to Grant. Grant to Drew. Drew, plenty of time, plenty of space. Misses it, and Dean has the rebound. Dean looking for support. Campbell with it. Barron. All over Campbell, and is blown for it. Second personal foul for Barron. Third of the quarter for Neptunas. We are 1:13 away from the long break. Oh, Campbell's lost possession. He's got it back again. And anywhere from a Jacob white ball it will be. Drew. Campbell has been called. Wanting clarification. Dejunas finds the target. Not as high scoring as the first quarter so far. 15 all for this free throw, so shading it by one. Neptunas. Jakovic. There is Ziggins. Ziggins on the ball. Jump shot, misses. Catching us with the rebound, and Ventsfield's here are could pay the price for a poor finish to the quarter. They trail by three before those two free throws were given away, and now Majaka called for the foul on Campbell. That's a little theatrical in going down. Six of one, half a dozen of another. Shikness comes back into the fray. So Dean will try and pull the strings of one last attack for Ventspils. Oh, it's opened up for him. He swung it out. And a miscommunication. He's looking for Campbell. Came off Zidin's, and the Tunis have possession. Campbell doesn't look very impressed. And Tunis call the timeout. The points in the paint considerably more for the home side.
Jay, you got hit.
Baskets are up against Pauk by five towards the end of the second quarter, 33-28. So this becomes a very important game for Neptunas and Ventspils now, with the German side in front against Pauk. for a very interesting game next week. Eventsville's Eventsville and Park both lose as Drew Drive lays up 7. And that is the end of the first half. And Klaipeda lead by 38 points to 31. They've won both quarters. And that is the game stats at the half-time break. Eventsville still shooting at only 30% in 2 points. That needs to improve, whereas Neptunus' three-point percentage needs to improve. Well, we'll see what happens after the break, but certainly the rebounding is helping Neptunus dominate this game. That's that. All those three exactly the same. So Drew, who had 10 points early on, had 6, sorry, early on, moves on to 10. Dean has 12. And just the 2 steals in the game of Jacob and Zelionis. Mark Drew backed up by Giorgunas. Dean backed up by Gorbis. Gorbis has 2 3 pointers. But this one very evenly poised. Eventsville could comfortably come back into this one, only trailing by 7, and they need to, just in terms of the group and qualifying for the postseason. So, it's the halftime break. Takes by the fans, make their way out onto the concourse for refreshment, but let's have a look at some of the highlights. This was what the opening couple of seconds of the game. Larry Drew putting through for 3. So that's been about it for the 3-point stats for Neptunus. They have it's 2 of 11. But certainly they've done good work inside compared to Ventspils, who have not been good for inside. Dean, the exception to that rule. 2 from 4, but Zakis 1 from 5. And the likes of Chinokas 1 from 4. Dean 2 from 2 from downtown. 2 from 4 from inside. Gorbis 2 from 3 from downtown. Both of them with big hang time. Zakis has not had the best of games. Grant 2 from 7 inside. Barron, just the 2 points for him. He's had a quiet first half as Jimmy Barron. Sure that will turn change. Giorgunas on the fast break points. Crowd enjoy those ones. And here are the 3-pointers from Gorbis. Stout. The first of them, absolute beauty. Oh, excuse me, that's Zelionis for his only 3-pointer. Grant enjoying his little tussle, he wins the follow-up points. Barron, those are his only points of the game so far. Lovely drive along the baseline. But they've been good on the rebounds. Neptunus. That is why they have themselves a 7-point lead. So Ben Spill's having all to do in this second half. Zach is finally getting his first shot on target after some pretty poor efforts early on. They trail by seven. Definitely achievable in pulling that one back. They could do with the win, with Pauk trailing by seven at home at half time against Oldenburg. That was towards the end, misunderstanding. And, Dean, Zedins and Campbell. The coach who's next doesn't look too impressed, but Drew has had a good game. Fans are enjoying it. And this one is on the balance. It's the home side that lead by seven. We'll go for a quick break. Please join us for the second half shortly.
Pirmoji raidė. Taip, kažkur ten. Šitas kamuoliukas keliauja po areną. Tai yra, jūs negalit jo užlaikyti ilgiau negu 2 sekundės. Jūs metat per rankas ir, aš pasakysiu, stop. Tas, kas turės kamuoliuką, laimės 25 pakvietimus į šeštadienio, sausio 21 dieną vykstančią TTT kazino Lietuvos krepšinio lygos kovą prieš Lietuvos rytą. Čia, šitą areną. 25 kvietimai. Dabar kamuoliukas pradeda keliauti. Jis pradeda keliauti. Jis keliauja po salę. Mesti ten į kitą pusę. Tik ne į aikštelę. Mes kristų pažiūrnos tobe. Gerai. Mesti dešinaikų. Jis keliauja. Kamuoliukas turi keliauti. Po visą areną. Mesti toliau. Labai gerai metą, man patikė. Būkit draugiški, dalykime, slaikina. Kamuoliukas turi keliauti. Mes ir toliau, va tai, gerai. Labai gerai, jis kažkur nukrito. Jisai dar keliauja. Tas kamuoliukas, kur jis yra, mes ir toliau į vaikai. Gerai, o šaunuolis. Toliau, aš skaičiuosiu nuo 5 ir kažkas įtrės. Toliau meskit, ne tarp savęs mėtykitės. Šitas žaidimas skatina jūs dalintis gerą emociją. Taip, galbūt jūs nelaimėsit, galbūt laimės kažkas, bet pasistengime. Reikia nedaug lieka laiko. Dar 5 sekundės, 4, metame toliau, 3, toliau meskime, toliau. Jūs negalite laikyti to kamuoliuko, turi atsidurti kitam sektoriui turi atsidurti, nes ten per daug pažįstamo atsisėdo. Kamuoliukas turi keliauti. Taip, 3, 2, metam. Ir kas pagauna, tas laimė. Ateikit čia.
Welcome back to the Shiva Tilio Arena in Klaipėda in Lithuania. We're at halftime in this Group C Basketball Champions League clash. Neptūnas Klaipėda lead Ventspils by 38 points to 31. This a key game as both sides look to finish as high up in the group to get a better draw in the regular season. And of course, Neptūnas Klaipėda looking to try another finish first or second, and in doing so, get through to the second playoff round, avoiding round one. Neptūnas, though, come into this game at the back of 3 losses in the competition. In fact, last weekend they won their first game in 7 in all competitions, or first game in 8, in fact, in all competitions. Their first win since December the 14th. And that was against Varese in the Basketball Champions League on the road. And, well, since then they lost to Asvel Lyon, 64-68, lost to Rue Basket 69-73, and to Pauk 73-82. Ventspils, they're on a 4-run streak, and they beat Neptūnas 66-61 the first time round. 79-63 against Rosa Radon. The USEC 97-86, Varese 88-82 away. Lyon at home 77-72. That was a big win for the Latvian side. Still win the league, Neptūnas, if they win this game and their last remaining game, and Lyon lose their last game, which is away to USAC next week. There's intensity about the starting five for Neptūnas in this game. game got underway. They brought it right out with Drew scoring a three-pointer in the opening moments. And they take it into the second half. Quarter three underway. Neptunus Klaipeda leading by 7, 38-31. Against the Latvian side, Ventspils in a key Group C clash. There's the layup. Gulbis reduces the arrears to 5. Grant and to get Junas. Johnson awaits. Here is Johnson. Drew. Johnson up against Dean. And Dean is called. He's some physical defense. You can see the physicality. And Dean. First personal foul of the match. Nice backside by Zakis. Two quick fouls in the opening 45 seconds for Ventspils. It's under a bit of pressure. Drew. Slide, but it buys him some time. Find the target. His average as Dean stretches and reaches the net. Grant, that's all for Gary Grant. Still going, or somehow laying up was Janakis. Okay, Junas. Johnson for 3, too much on it. Dean picks up the rebound and then picks up the foul. Larry Drew. Well, averaging 8.8 per season, as we've seen, he hit a massive 31 against Puck last week. From 2 makes it a 3-point game, and from a Neptunus point of view, Ventspils just won't go away, will they? Ventspils fans will be pretty happy with the way that their side is sticking with the hosts. Drew. Oh, good. Junas just about keeps it in play. Lovely bit of skill by Geir Junas, swings out to his right hand side. Here comes the shot. It's a 2-pointer by Kachinas. Points in the evening for Kachinas now. This one's gone against. Kachinas picks up foul. And two team fouls each. About 2.5 minutes in, just over. Has it up over the top. Zakis keeps it alive. Campbell, he also keeps it alive, and that shot not away in time. A good defense. Tinokas couldn't get it away. Turnover in possession. Be a coach. Notice he's He's going at it head to head. Once again, can't believe it. Question of every foul that goes against him. Once again, finding the target. Swings it out to Gorbis, back to Campbell. Zakis takes on the three-pointer, and Zakis drains the three-pointer. Wow, what a shot from Ronald Zakis. Zakis doesn't hit many. 3 from 10. Dean picks up the foul. Threw over the top to Grant. Raise up his option and decides just to pop up the two-pointer. Find space for the jump shot. Taken by Nitinokas. 48 plays 44 with 5:40 remaining in the third quarter. From miles downtown, too much on it. Picked up by Gorbis and given to Dean. Zakis. His foot was it? Yes, it was. So his arms are say he was pulled back. He's not going to get much change from the officials. Carter comes into the frame. Missed the last two games. Giannis also into the fray. Grant. His strength to give himself some space up against Elionis. Over the top, and foul comes in. Elionis just clean that right leg. Out. Second one drops. It's a 5-point game. Substitutions are happening. Leonis out. Zakis in. Kaskas there, number 15. Barron. Kaskas. Barron. All sorts. And it's gone against Shikshnius. Foul. Look at Nias over Nitinokas. He's not happy. Probably feeling it with 6 of 1, half a dozen or another. Dean. Nitinokas. Nias Chancellor's gone. Chance to have fouled, so more turnover. Drew Johnson. Shurikauskas. Barron drives to just inside the paint. Rebound eventually picked up by Zelionis. Here is Dean. Dean takes on the jump shot. Too much on it. Rebound goes to Drew, who's away. Drew lays up for two. Dean opting not to challenge and pick up the foul. Just beating Zelionis to it. To take his compatriot out in the air. 15 points, just over halfway to his points tally last week. Dean then. The line. Serkis comes back on. Dean reduces the arrears by one. Reduces it by two. 52. Plays 47. Johnson from downtown sinks the three-pointer. First one of the evening. Only three-pointer. Dean's blind pass comes back off Drew. Still has possession. And the blind pass, too high. The teammate, Igor Stout. So not the best passage of play for Willie Dean. Junas to Grant. Barron. To Junas. Grant. Johnson. No. Rebound. Carter. Two-pointers though, as Gorgas has put on his backside. 100% for Ben Spills, 55 for Tunas. Can't believe it. Needs to give it plenty of air, doesn't he? Trademark. He's shooting here this evening. Two. Back to six. So again, 45-49. Yajunas. Manages to get back upright again over the top as he's double teamed. Means there's got to be a spare man somewhere. And run out of time and possibly out of court. Jacob. Defense from Ventspils, and to be honest, was in net, number 11. Jakovic. Campbell. De Leonis. Oh, nice pass. And it drops for Zidens. That was really well worked. 55 plays 51. Rebound from Matt Johnson's shot. Campbell. Stell. Still going. And time, space. Zelionis makes it a 2-point game. This is a strong finish to the quarter by the visitors. Zelionis not at his best so far tonight. Just on, was it? Doesn't matter. Came back and Zelionis is there. Pick up the rebound and the chance here for Ventspils to possibly draw level. Jakovic. Zelionis to Campbell. Pitched out. And the travelling call sees the opportunity go away. Grant back in, Sakis back in. So the final seconds of this third quarter. Campbell has it. And he doesn't get the call. Catching us. Physical. He gets away. Drew. As the shot clock ticks to one, he takes on the 3-pointer. He has it! Oh, the buzzer beater gets the crowd off their feet. And Larry Drew makes it 58-53 at the end of the third quarter. Oh, Stell had that opportunity to level it up, turn possession over with the travel, and Drew drives it now through the heart with the three-pointer, 58-53 with 10 to go. So the stats just ticking across the bottom of the screen. Well, well, well. Pauk imploded at home to over here, baskets. German side 57-39 now. So this one becomes very key, and what it also means is that Pauk will be, there are never in any danger of getting Oldenburg or Neptunus, but now they definitely can't. And, it will give Ventspils a little bit of a breather, a breathing space, as they take them on in their last match, although Pat did beat them in Greece. Game day seven, Ventspils, as we see Drew going to work. Nineteen. Game leader Dean for Ventspils on 18. Been excellent in his last couple of games, Larry Drew. Egor Stahl then gets this final quarter underway. Ventspils trailing by five. They trailed by seven at the end of the second quarter. Very close to levelling it up. Zakis has to reach high. Ah, those weren't firing at all in the first half, but they're firing now. Ventspils, as they have for the last three quarters, score first. Here is Grant. Comes in from Zakis. Look from Zakis to Grant. Drew has a little bit of space. Pass it back out to Giorgunas. Giorgunas takes it to the free throw line, unleashes the shot, wipes his feet and drops. Here's Campbell. Campbell still going, and Barron all over the back of him. Here is Zidins. Zakis looking for the three-pointer. Grant with the rebound. As well to keep it in, fires it back out, and driving to the line goes Giorgunas. Giorgunas finds the two-pointer. Timeout called. Ventspils coach Rudnieks. So Neptunus lead by seven. They are looking for their first win in the competition since December the 14th. Campbell drives, sends it back out to Stout. Stout draws the foul. It's a foul. Dean to Campbell, who once again drives the channel, feeds Zakis. Giorgunas picked himself up out of the matting. Jacob. Drew. On slips. Gets it out to Majeka. Shot clock is red. He has to take it on. Two-pointer. His foot on the line. So Campbell. Dean drops out. Dean takes the pass, and Campbell goes upstairs. Grant read it well. and rejection as Zach has looked for the alley-oop. Really good defense from Jerry Grant. Campbell now has four personal fouls. Just to be careful. Here is Drew. In front of him, Drew just comes back out. Shot clock turns red, he'll take it on himself. That looks a little short, it is short. Dean. Campbell. Over the top now, going to work as Zidins. Nope. Drew with the rebound. 7-point game still. It's been single figures throughout this one. The Ventspils have been in front only once by a single point. That was the start of the second quarter. Well, that'll help. And for the first time, the Tunis have a double-digit lead. It's 10 points now, courtesy of the Majakut three-pointer, his first, leading 67, place 57. And Ventspils now need to find an extra gear. The mystery pointer won't help things as Kalkas gets the rebound. So if Ventspils lose this, it's going to be a straight shootout for 4th-5th as Ventspils take on Pauk next week. Shot comes in, and it's in from Kalkas, and Neptunas are the ones finding the extra gear here, not Ventspils. And it is 8 unanswered points that put the home side firmly in control of this one. 12-4 they lead in this 4th quarter. Well, those 6 more offensive rebounds from Tunis that have led to secondary points, which looks like so much easier. Hello. Interesting use of the facilities and the entertainment in the timeout. Well, patience was the key from Coach Muzniak and Ventspils in that timeout. And they've got just under 6 minutes to try and turn 14 points or 13 points around. They need 14 if they're going to win it. Dean draws the foul. Dealt over the top, no one there. Zelionis lays up for 2. Kalkas to Barron to Johnson to Genus. Corvis in front of Gear Junas goes aerial. Kalkas is there. He put away the missed layup from his teammate. And fouls has been to drive to the net. Campbell, be careful. discipline. Layup comes in from Stell. Grant moves it to Barrett. Barrett has been quiet today. It's the 2 points still for Barrett. Jacob comes through for two. Plenty of hair time, you know who that is, Maris Gorbis. Here goes Barron. Barron with only his second score of the night, well down on his season average. Gorbis steps outside, comes back in. Zakis, too much on it, found with the rebound. Grant. Well, the Neptunus fans are going to see a first win in this competition for a month. Grant puts through, it's the largest lead, 78-64. Zakis, Dean. He misses, rebound is Barron's. Really close for the first, what, 3.5 quarters. Neptunus still finding the extra gear towards the end of this one. So pull away. Look at that, two goals this quarter. Barron finds a three-pointer. The game is now safe as Dean misses. Drew brings it away. So it's a three-way fight for the top spot in Group C between Lyon, Neptunas and Oldenburg. Fourth and fifth, well, it's a straight shootout between Ventspils and Pauk. Pauk not showing any sign of coming back. 46-61 against Oldenburg. So the top three winning this week. Lyon, remember, can finish no lower than second. Barron takes on the three-pointer. Rebound board under control by Gorbis. Inside the final two. Here goes Stout. And Giannis. And the two-pointer. Drew. through the repertoire of skills. Takes on the three-pointer. Oh, he drains it as well. And the lead is 18. Wow, what a disappointing end to this game for Ventspils, because they made such a game of it up until the fourth quarter. Delionis on the target. Harry Jude now to 22 points. Goes again, being the real fall in the side. It comes back out. He's going to have another pop at it. Well, no, he's just going to run the clock down. Back out to Sharakauskas. Too much on it. Leonis brings in the rebound. This will be the final play. And it comes. Not happening, and Neptunas finally get the W after a month of losses in the Basketball Champions League. They've got the better of Ventspils, 84-68 the final score. Well, a great result for the Neptunas fans. They eliminate Ventspils for the race for the top three finish. And with Pauk losing to Oldenburg, it is Lyon, Neptunas and Oldenburg battling it out for the top three. The stats there, well, the rebound, 11 offensive to only 4 offensive for Ventspils, a telling reason why the home side have run out winners by 16 points. Larry Drew down the right of the screen, recording his set. Second best game of the season, 22 points and an efficiency of 24. Also his second best of the season. The visitors, oh, really, it was only Willie Dean who stood out. Gorbis with 13 points and Zelionis with 12. But Drew leading the way. And the Neptunas fans delighted to return to winning ways in the Basketball Champions League. Well, they threatened to come back in the third, but it was a very disappointing fourth. In fact, the second and fourth quarters disappointing for Ventspils. Just the one. Quarter in double figures, so the fans will go home disappointed. For Ventspils, certainly not for the home side. Drew leading the charge, instrumental in everything good for them. Home side, he started the ball rolling inside the opening 5 seconds with a three-pointer. It just went wrong, didn't it, in that final quarter. Passage of play from Dean as his blind pass goes astray. There's some good work in there as well, though, from the inside. Zelionis hooking up with Zakis. Just Gorbis off the bench, 13 points, otherwise it was 8. Stel and Zedins with 4 apiece. Four from the bench for the home side. Drew's buzzer beater at the end of the third just perhaps gave the home side a little bit of belief going into that final quarter. Ventspils just leading the once. match in the second quarter. But as I say, Lyon, Neptunus and Oldenburg fighting it out for the top three in Group C. Ventspils will take on Pauk at home next week for a straight shootout for fourth and fifth. So, well, top four will make it into the next round. Fifth place team might well do so as well, but we'll just have to wait to see how it shakes down after all of the regular season games have been played. Barron had one of his quieter games, just the 7 points when he's been averaging over 15. Ventspils, well, just didn't have an answer to the Neptunas game in that fourth and final quarter. Well, that's it from Lithuania. Neptunas have their first win since December the 14th, and they are still very much in the hunt to top Group C. Good night.